city school and they are from India.
Okay. Which class?
12th class.
All of them are 12th?
You are from which class? 12th. All are from 12th class.
Very young. Class 12. What? So preparations are going fine?
Yes.
You have been through such lectures previously? Have you attended these kind of lectures? Don't recall it.
Your honor, comfort and safety
class, all women everywhere.
Can do better than this. Okay, so I can put hundreds of reasons why one should join Benami, but I have listed a few and I can go over each of these points one by one. So these are job satisfaction, professional growth, variety of ways to work. Self pride of safeguarding your homeland. All of us are capable of government in protecting. Absorbed in field locations, active locations, people don't care for their life and they will follow your command to the last word. Your career progression, your grooming, your growth will be continuous and you will be offered ample opportunities at every stage to enhance your personal as well as professional growth. You will be offered various career courses, various professional courses, various technical courses. How many of you know that all IITs have got M.Tech vacancies for Indian Army officers? Are you aware? The premier institutes of India offer courses to Army officers. Are you aware? You guys have no idea about it? Not aware? Okay. Most of the IITs and the premier institute that you can think of, all of these offer courses to or vacancies to the Indian Army officers, even as part of a resettlement program. Okay? Language courses in Indian language as well as foreign language courses. You go to China, you go to Iran, you go to Australia, though it is English, but you go to Egypt, you go to various countries to pick up their languages.
Sponsor or give you 2 years of leave to pursue that higher degree. I am not aware if any other organization is doing that. In this sector, that a study leave of 2 years, which is full paid, with all cost privileges, and you carry out your own thing of liking. I don't have to highlight it. You guys are from Army Public School, and KV is so well aware what I have, all kind of adventurous activities are thrown open to the Army team. Some of these are these. Horse riding is to go out for polo. Polo is a sport of royals only. But in Army, anybody can enjoy polo or pick up polo.
The answers are much more. So it comes to really need 1.25 lakh or somewhere around that. And as you grow in that, you have a like any other organization, keeps growing. So Army is a well-paid organization. Salary increment, every annual salary increment is almost guaranteed. And
what I want to highlight is this point.
Assured job security is likely. We have just witnessed a great pandemic or where a number of people were on the verge of losing their jobs. Or the civil world was facing tremendous challenge in terms of COVID management. As far as Army is concerned, we have been lucky that job security was never an issue. And secondly, we have been able to manage COVID in a better way. And our medical facilities are still available to all of us. So there be a need. About social status, what I want to say, which you are clear outside, you will talk to. Okay? I remember when I was a gentleman committed to Naime, we went to Mumbai, something that we can't even imagine. But he, with that stature, that position, was in me, the bungalow of the DOC. All I want to say that Ami has plenty to offer you. In the same line, I will tell you one more incident. Again, when we were undergoing our training in NBA, every witness was empty of NBA. Anybody of you have been to NBA? National Business Academy. Okay. So he said that I've been to all the academies, I've been to West Point, which is the academy of US
anything to take. I told you that I come from Sanic background, and I come from a Sanic school which has got excellent academic standards. So in my school, not too many people came to Army. Most of them went to AIIMS or IIT or went abroad, and most of my students are today abroad. Today, I'll hand over the podium to Sameer.
Good morning to all, dear faculty members, students, and Captain Sameer. Defense and guarding the border, 20%. Well, one of my close men, that he was in, along with me in class 12, his elder brother, he was in Army. So one fine day he came to meet me, and he told me, I asked him the same doubt, sir, I had this notion in mind, that why has chosen August 9th on this dignity at an international level, representing India at a global level. UN mission. As we are all aware, the Indian Army sends its forces as part of UN peacekeeping force, which is a commendable job done by Indian Army. Indian Army is basically training-based army. The main focus of Indian Army is to train its people so that they are always ready for any contingency or any call given by the nation. Such training exercises are conducted throughout the year. And let me tell you, we just had a training exercise when we were in India from various countries, around 4 to 6 reps from various countries had come to India. Now when we had interacted with them, we got to know about their army, how do they operate, are they superior to us, as we want, what is reflected in media, or are they staying like us?
But really, yeah. Now just imagine the importance of Indian Army Chief with respect to some aware of this individual. Yeah. Yeah. Neeraj Chopra is a attached person in 4th Rajvik. He recently won a gold medal in javelin throw at Tokyo Olympics. Now this was possible because he was selected for the Olympics. This is Lieutenant Colonel Rajavardhan Singh Rathore. He is a double trap shooter. He won gold medal in, silver medal in 2004 Athens Olympics. These are some of the sports persons, as you said. There are numerous sports persons excelling at various levels, national, international levels. I just want to highlight that Indian Army
amount of training that individual is trained and the emotional attachment with the country is developed throughout his life. As I mentioned, as the sir had brought up earlier, there are various vacancies in IIT, IIM for higher education in MTech, then management courses. So life doesn't stop once you enter India or the IIM. There is always something more to do, something that you can pursue.
Good morning everyone. I respect you greatly and all the students. It's lovely to be here. And now I am carrying this presentation ahead with what we will call life today now. Before me, you will be told what does this life include, how do you ever live. First, I would like to say the life in the Indian Army, unlike all other professions, you be a lawyer, you be a corporate manager, you be a doctor, it starts the day, starts with the job. As you know, a doctor, my life starts when I start operating on people or doing something. Unlike that, Army, your life starts the day you step into a trainer's head. Your life has changed, it will never be the same. You'll be groomed, you'll be trained, you'll be polished into what you call a gentleman or a lady officer. This training now, first of all, it is very hard and it is very challenging. You understand Indian Army, as I earlier brought up, it is a very challenging job, it is a very difficult job. Therefore, you have to be trained for it, trained very hard for it. There will be days where you will be very low, you will find things. There will be moments when you will be like, I cannot do this. But that is a part of the training. They best change your ranks. You have the stars or what I have now in the There is no moment like that. A year, 4 years, NDA, IIT, whatever. That moment when you stand and you have sparkling stars on your shoulders. That happiness, that pride, that joy that you see on your family's face. It is incomparable to anything, any day package, any Indian college course. Okay, you will have friends for life. Today, all of the staff officers that we stand, we have any trouble, we need any information, we need any help, all of us serve fathom and challenges that we never thought we will be able to do. So you will find people in your life that are very dear to you and will always be with you no matter what. Be it a professional problem, be it a happy moment, which happens. This is a great moment when you become a commercial officer and you are now ready to take on the world. You had always dreamed that I'll be an officer, I'll do this, I'll do that. All these moments do not come to any conventional
world, The two countries have been fighting since 1918, if I remember correctly. The life of a soldier in Siachen Glacier is something that nobody in this entire world or entire earth can fathom. The temperatures are beyond minus 50, your entire lifestyle, your mind goes through an amount of stress that you cannot think of, your body goes through an amount of stress that you cannot think of. For months you cannot speak, there is no mobile, there is no telephone, nothing there. You cannot speak to your family, you have these 10-15 people living with you, that is your only interaction with them. And
you can be there onwards, there onwards, the young. You are going on the leaf, there is no stone at the onward, you are going to your parents. This is the life which is very different. You do not get to see here, you do not get to see this life ever in metros or any other good place. This is where our continued help and the soldiers, the boys who are here, are actually helping the country handle a task that is. It is an insurmountable responsibility on each and every soldier that is present in this area. Deployment along LC and GLK. LC is a light patrol, it is a disputed boundary for basic understanding of everyone. It is not an international boundary, there is a distance along country boundary. We have soldiers in JK standing on an LC. LC, it is not an international
that is slightly troubled with insurgency and again convoys. People are carrying weapons. Understand, these are not difficult. I don't mean to discourage anyone. But this is the core part of this protection. That photograph that we see, a man, this is your basic job. I have to protect people. I have to protect my country. Deployed along LAC and JAC and Northeast. Again, you can see in our Northeast borders also along with China, we have troops deployed where the leaders protecting our identity duties. Internal security duties.
This happens in states like JK and all, where you reach out to the local, you reach out to the community that is troubled by insurgency, by counter-terrorism or by something. There are people of my country that are troubled due to political or any other disturbances, and an army officer, you are taught and tasked to reach out to them and help them. It might be helping out children, it might be helping out women, it might be helping out youth with new jobs. It is again a very prestigious responsibility, I believe, that is given to the army. Adventure. For all those who look for adventure in life, there is no other profession that will give you an adrenaline rush like in the army. Rock climbing. This is something adventure like this. You get to climb all the others. You get to showcase your skills. You get to achieve excellence in them. Barriers for all those people who love guiding. You have a lot of barriers in competitions. And officers, as everyone forms very well in them, it is something that is supported a lot. Operating mighty missions, I believe, especially for the boys with big guns, missiles, and all of this, what you see in Call of Duty, and I don't know, any number of games and movies, this is a real thing, and this is a profession that will give you a chance to take on. Then I come to everything. This is the professional part of it, but why do we say this alike? Army just does not task you with difficult jobs. They give you a life that I believe anyone would dream of living. You get to become a homicide boy. In a normal setup, you must have school friends in other schools or somewhere outside of the countries. Golf is not something that any other profession will tell you that, okay, good evening, you can go and learn golf. You get a golf membership in places like Delhi or Lucknow or Srinagar, people pay lakhs and you still have a waiting of 4 years. You cannot even join the golf club. Army will give you the best golf clubs, it will give you an opportunity to learn this class. Terrorists. Avenues which in any other life, you have to struggle to subscribe to them, to learn to them. Army encourages you to learn to them. You will be told, pick up a sport. In an entire training, there will have to be one of those sports that you play. I can probably say that I joined my academy, I was not a very sporty person. I had never played one sports that much. But how we taught me, they play badminton, I play handball. After graduation, I joined the army. But I am a professional that encourages me to do so. That it is okay. At any age, you can or other ways to that way to play in the army. Everything is there to me. Army again, professional life covered, your space, your living lifestyle covered, also it takes care of the remote places or do not have an opportunity to get good education for their children. That is a murder on a soldier's mind, an officer's mind, and what do I do about my children in my family? That is why such a great school has been opened and started. You have great accommodation, you have hospitals. Anywhere that you are posted or deployed, you will have special doctors to take care of you, of your family, of your dependents, your parents, or whoever. Cleaning and cold medicine. You go to the best cities in the world, you go to the best colonies. I still believe there is no better place to live than Canada. The cleanliness, the hygiene, the way it is maintained, all basic. You will not get that in anywhere in the best of metro life. Now coming to the main thing, what does this job entail in terms of monitoring measures for us? First of all, during training, whenever you are in training, you are facing a cycle of 56,000. You have crazy fatigue even during your training, and you have anxiety rations. Your entire ration of food and the kind of food you should eat to maintain your body strength is given by your employer. Post commissioning. As earlier brought up, you start in the cycle somewhere around this and as per your back structure, getting deeper into it. Pre-medical treatment. I believe you do not realize it, but this is a very big benefit that the army gives us. Today you go to MAPS, protest any hospital. For a basic consultation of any small thing, you might have fever, you might have a small surgery like appendix. It will cost you a lot, you will run a lot, it will take a lot of mental strength. But army is something that you need to pre-medical treatment, not only for yourself, but your dependents. Dependents would be your wife, children, or your parents, for you. 60 days of as well as 20 days of casualty. This is a game changer. No other profession will give you this much time. You are posted in remote locations, you are posted in different tasks. Therefore, army gives you adequate time to go back to your family, take care of your family, do your important job at home. No other profession will give you this long pain. We were involved as a brought up as a person in the army, you are given five positions. Army Welfare Housing Facilities. In army, we have an AWHO, Army Welfare Housing Organization. In great cities, colonies are created, and all serving persons of the Indian Army can apply to those houses. Which is, and they are at very affordable rates, because as you could see, in other high-end colonies or something, it is difficult for you to buy. You probably are not comfortable with the structure, the colony space as such, but AWHO has great houses where your neighbors would be also your fellow officers at the time. Reservation in engineering and medical colleges for children. As army officers, tomorrow if my children want to pursue MBBS, IIM or something, they will give entrance in anything, but there is a reservation. Prestigious colleges of our country have a reservation. That this much percentage will be given to a defense student. Post-retirement, you draw pension at 50% of the last day of whatever life you were. Along with that, you are gradually, the medical methods that the army has will be with you throughout your life. You're serving, you're retired, the medical benefits, the insurance cover, facilities like CSD, they continue for your entire life for you and your friend. MBA program for retired officers. When someone retires from the Indian Army is such a
Thank you.
first lecture that came in, discipline. The basic aim of any training academy would is to make discipline a part of your life. It is a part of your personality, it is a part of your conduct always. You are at home, you are anywhere, you are disciplined always. That is the basic ethos of the Indian Army. Army cannot function without discipline. We can handle all difficulties, but discipline is the core part. Now, what does actual difference that we do? Every year, approximately 3 lakh students apply for it. They have an entrance exam, 3 lakh students appear for it, only 0.1%, which is 50 to 350, get the chance to join this prestigious academy. Qualifications, you just have to be a 12th graduate, these are the 8 minutes for NDA. How do you whether you are fit to be a part of the Indian Army? Then there is a mention. However, this is a short term scheme. I believe some of you might be aware. Indian Army, you can get permanent commission and short service commission. Short service commission is for 10 years. After 10 years, you are judged by the Indian Army whether you are fit to be given a permanent commission or not. You also have a choice. NCC specialization. All those who are given NCC do not require to get any entrance exam. If you have an NCC certificate, you can apply directly and go for NCC. Once you clear that, you have a medical, merit-based and training. I will give you a short but good glimpse of what this life includes, how this life starts for you, how it, what it involves as per your job, as per your everyday life. And say this, every day when you get up and look yourself in the mirror, you're happy. I'm every day happy. I chose this profession. It makes me feel proud. Before going, the best moment of
permanent commission directly, even lady officer.
subordinate function, you will have a span as long as any other hand pronouncement. Think it depends on what.
Thank you, all the best.
And babies, I express my gratitude to Colonel Raj Abhinav, Vaku Sena Medal, Commanding Officer, 14th Large Red, Medal Company, Captain Sumit for taking out their time from their busy schedule and delivering a motivational lecture. Indeed, these motivational lectures are the need of the hour. And I'm sure this student must be motivated to join the Army. Thank you very much, sir.